Tadri number legi samrola di chidru dili shugui.
I'd like to welcome everyone to this afternoon teaching.
Tadne tuzu gadrze tuzu suma podrbe. Ah, hagmaza. Arani hagum. Quiet, the Hawaii, the organize. Oh, no, it's okay. It's okay. Oh. Nin don't know chair, Madame, to the Hakum.
We're pretending to know what we're doing, but we don't know how we're supposed to speak.
It's okay. That the name Dina Lolia and it Shuloga Subadi Jelam Gundu Rangula, Tozi Nomo Gamata. Does in Maroon Seven and send up Donny Dobber shows. Then this one shot.
The third verse reads, in my every action, I will watch my mind. In the moment destructive emotions arise, I will confront them strongly and avert them, since they will hurt both me and others.
Maroon with Chevasidusane, and a goody, Kashre Tsubun of Zedan, Gu Tombo, on the disweaver. That did it give him a job.
So here in English it says hurt. Actually, the Tibetan is Marungwa, which is a little different. Marungwa, Nupa is like causing harm, but Marungwa is more like. More like making you wild or making you rough or harsh.
Tini du sana da nyomu basadi nyomu sadi keshin keshin. Ani kashura ji kolia kumdi chandu bisa ani kali kali ji mik suru ji min tangba ke yundu ne ani si mitukjar bichesi ke yo mare ta yimine kombe wang somarbe ta ji su su chalon chom chose ta kuryo da ta na singi ne dang ge kembe ani mi di kali kali ji mi dukzub jen shilya ani koran je kachu cha ju yares.
So as the afflictions occur, as they arise, we get habituated to them, and so then we become rough or become wild. At first, when the afflictions first occur, you're not a bad person, but then you get habituated to them, and as you get habituated and used to them, then whenever you're in that sort of situation or environment, then your mind gets rough and disturbed.
Tadu shivin disre. That tiba chijun sanata, taga the sangi yusumbe, and a chia tamsegi, and a say, so the nyomuba, duyagi nyambule, suma mato begi, shayo maras, three dusane, and also shuin yamlin, shengi, kasagi, shu condition yamlin shavina. Tata jigasure. Nyerang TV chain Yamlin Chevin and Dra, Yanaji TV chain between Yamlin Chevin and Dra, Sanga Dosi TV chain Yamlin Chevin, Gandar and Ming, that Yamlin Chia Chu Kandiji in a minute. It's somebody Yomu Vinyamura Joyzi. The Jagger Tornay, that Yamlin Chia Wars, that in Nanga of the Chain Yamlin Chia Nanga, Chu Lambda Droman Jog Nanga of Zodi, the Chadi orders.
Whether we're talking about the foundation or great vehicle Dharma, whether we're talking about, or any of the Dharma of the that the Buddha taught. It's all an antidote for afflictions and nothing else. So no matter what Dharma, any person who's practicing Dharma, no matter what Dharma it is that they're practicing, whether this is the Dharma of the hearers and the Pratyeka Buddhas, whether it's the Mahayana Dharma, whether it's the secret mantra Vajra Dharma, no matter what name you call the Dharma you practice, all of it needs to become an antidote for the afflictions. This is the critical point of the Dharma. And it is whether our Dharma is functioning, whether it is working as the Dharma or not, primarily comes down to this. And so this is like the summary of all the practice of all three vehicles of the Buddhist practice. And so it's like the vows or the restraint. The vows are restraint of our body, speech, and mind. And so the practice of the three different types of vows, the three different types of restraint, is something that is considered extremely important in Tibet. And the reason for this is because you could say that, like, the particular feature of Tibetan Buddhism is that it is the practice of all three. Excuse me. The reason for this is that the particular feature of Tibetan Buddhism is that in Tibetan Buddhism we practice the three vehicles all together within the being of a single individual. This is considered critical. This is considered very important. And so in order to practice the Dharma of the three vehicles, you first have to have the practice of the three types of vows within any one individual. And so for that reason, the three types of vows are considered a different topic, and there is particular research and teaching into these three types of vows.
Dombasum sade, Kansa Mindrav Sumlia, Bena, Kansa A, B, C, the Nichi Sumlia, and A delia, Sustave Domba, B delia, Jerusalem Domba, C delia, and Sanga Domba, the Nichi Narin Chiaina, and the Lena Richard, that the Kansus Kasuji Kakasu Chen Yamajati, Lena Richard. In a gum delia. Kharsu
If when we practiced the three different types of vows, we had different individuals like person A, person B, and person C. Person A would practice the individual liberation vows, the Pratimoksha. Person B would practice the Bodhisattva vows, and person C would practice the secret mantra Vajrayana vows, then it would be easy to practice like that. So if you have different individuals practicing the different types of vows, they're all easy. But it's not when we don't practice it with three different individuals practicing three different types of vows. We have one individual who's doing the practice of all three. And when you do, one individual practices all three different levels of vows, then sometimes the vows conflict with each other. So when you come to a situation where if you behaved according to the Pratimoksha vows, the precepts of the Pratimoksha vows, then it might conflict with your Bodhisattva vow. Or if you were to hold the practices of the secret mantra Vajrayana vows to be most important, then it might contradict your Pratimoksha precepts. And so when there are these different conflicts and contradictions, then it becomes difficult to practice. And so I think that actually this is the area where that gives the greatest difficulty to people who are practicing Buddhism.
Nyamlin Yingbu Senata, the Chadi Yorla, Kale Kashu de Chadi Yore. The day you said that the discussion Mangushai or D Toliachi Kashu Kabasu, Shizu Mangushaiochi. That you say, that Hundra Yang, yet didn't she had the Tidig Shizu Dizuko Kizamare. Kandar Yang, Tinja Vigata, Domasum Yamlin Sadi, Tea, and the Kashu to Yumu Menyavodra. Then Bena ji susu tabe gi domba susu tabe domba se dusa bena tera ji ji kimbe gi domba ta rabjung gi domba ben kimba ra genye domba ar rabju chung wala ani kimba la pomoni ar rabjung la pomoni ar kada tin gi domba ar ta di zu di nyomong ba de sha somar be de sha la nyamba de ya chi da ji susu di Kashurtaji Wada de Lunalia, this Kashurtaji agreement of chess, agreement, Chikashur Lunalia, agreement chess, the Kashur, that so the Lunar Tone, Chichabuchi, Lusas. That the nation used to be Domasa, the condition, that changes some big, don't beg, Sir Lady Sana. And Dokashinana, Chanjusambala, Dushadi, and in Kashore, Numova Mains, that is Sanki Sunare, Caras and Chanjusambal Grand Nubadi, Grand Ninji Chamber, the Dinde Nubay, Chamber, the Ninji, Nubachambo Yavinza, Tigi, and Gandalpaji, Dushadi, but Gurtu user, Troll, as well, Lamji Tross Kitu user. That Yimine, Chanjusambi, and Yamlang Zodi Carasana, Yamlang Zodi. And it's about the Ninji, Chanju Sumasova. That name means Tetambe, Tegar, Gather of Chadivity, or Shedan. Chill you in Dusane, and a Shedan of Zube, Toto Gami, Shedan and Nimbo Dan. That name, Sanga Gigolia Mina, and Sanga Golina, was in Dusha Shedan, someone draws Kitu. Sanga Golia Zudi, Timuli Nimbo Dane. She Tamegi, Nashi Senator. dembar shenpa de doya ki chedo ane misege kora sanga tholom mangboji peju dang je ben ta kandar bena sirib le a dene garja de aju gyawa jinge sirib su 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 melon yishi sa no da shi yishi mangboji to ga ta dinje ge kol tene ya shib du che That is soon to do the Nomo of Timulia, Nimbo the Arab, the Jib says. Don Donna, somewhere is Nomo of Nimbondra. And this one you remember.
So the practice of the three types of vows.
Sochijon, Shendu, Sochijon.
No.
Sochijon. Mainly for that Jib Shena.
So the essence of the practice or the feature of Tibetan Buddhism is the practice of the three types of vows, and it is the most difficult type of vow. There has been a lot, or difficult part of the practice. There's been a lot of discussion about this, but here I'm not doing this merely for the sake of talking about this merely for the sake of being scholarly. Rather, primarily, it's about practice. Primarily, it's about how to make this into an antidote for your practice. For example, if we have the pratimoksha vows, the vows of individual liberation, there are the vows of the householders, the five lay precepts, and the fasting vows. There are the vows of the monastics, both male and female monastics. And so these precepts, whether lay or monastic precepts, are primarily antidotes for the afflictions. There's something where we work with our body and speech. It's like we have an agreement with our body and speech. We are primarily making sure not to act upon desire with our body and speech. When we come to the bodhisattva vow, however, it's different. In fact, in some sutras, the Buddha taught that for a bodhisattva, desire and attachment is not an affliction. And the reason for this is that the power of the bodhisattva comes from the power of loving kindness and compassion, and that attachment can be an aid in increasing our loving kindness and compassion. But what is a problem and what is contradictory of the bodhisattva practice, which is primarily the practice of loving kindness, compassion, and bodhicitta? What contradicts that is our hatred and aversion, and so we primarily try to stop the aversion, and we apply remedies for aversion. In the practice of the secret mantra Vajrayana, of course, we do work with all the afflictions, the attachment and the aversion, but the primary affliction that we work with is delusion, the delusion of grasping things as being real. And so in the secret mantra Vajrayana, we use many different methods in order to prevent ourselves from clinging to things as being real. And so this is why there's the description of the prajna and developing the wisdoms of the five Buddhas of the five families, the mirror-like wisdom, and so forth. This is because this is primarily as an antidote for delusion. And so to sum it all up, then basically all the Dharma becomes antidote for the afflictions.
That the name is that Digun Santana. I was in Yomodi Kashmir. That two can serve in a Takanda Yomo never draw chowders. Yomo never draw down here, Vesi Kashmir, Bena Susul Tuzuru Sweze. Kashmir common practice chair of the Tuzu in his. To the sushi, the meditation room, the dinner, the sushi, Tinji Sheshavina, and it's our mean, did you change your message? Yungo Amaras. shrine room dinal chibome go beyond shrine room somewhere go beyond meditation room that ring you sane so so lega chebe ko linare an dan singi mission dan jabe chebe ko linare khanda khang ko lin bi ne ta thana dine she ya ta jeju sebe gi jeba na she ju or thana be gera gera ching du sane ta dia ta da nyomo ba da jeba che do me ta se sha or es ta ina de zo da ji sib sha ro ba na dre du sane ta khan tra ya dine ji to ne en ka shwe nyomo da ta dine ji ga che che which is somewhere with that dig spirit somewhere with that the ningdop dang dana singe dinde ge gar chege ningdop dang chege garre ji de ne nubro de khadu yimi ne su su jelam khadi che ne ko ne di ko li ya ta nyam do ye go ya ji da nyam do ji nyom ba le ya ta khaju ne dong len che wa ru ta di cha di wa le su
And so whatever dharma we practice must be must function or must work as an antidote for the afflictions. And in order for the dharma to work as an antidote for an afflictions, then the way we often do it is we set aside a particular time and a particular place as our time and our place for practicing dharma. We have a meditation room, a shrine, and we go in there, we spend a few hours there, it's a little bit of time, and then we go there and we work at it in our meditation. And then at other times, we just let ourselves be ordinary, be normal, and you know, give our afflictions free rein. And if we do that, then we are not really practicing the Dharma. It does not really become Dharma practice. And so that is why it says, in my every action, so whatever we are doing, not just when we are meditating, not just when we are in our shrine room, we also have to do it all the time. It has to go beyond and extend beyond our shrine room and our meditation. So whatever job we're doing, whatever task we're doing, whenever we're making connection with other people, in any action that we are doing, we need to keep this in mind. It's often said in describing the conduct of a bodhisattva, it talks about how even when you tie your belt, you should see if this is connected with decreasing the afflictions or not. Now, of course, that's looking at it in very fine detail, but in any case, when we are trying to overcome the afflictions, when we're doing the Dharma and practicing the Dharma, if we want to have courage in the Dharma, if we want to have power in our Dharma practice, no matter whatever actions it is, we have to look at this in all of our actions and everything that we do. And once we do that, then we will be able to have that confidence, and we will be able to actually avert the afflictions.
Hindustani brings the Dharma into your life. Somewhere with the Tambe Shedi, Susu Mizinanola, Nijik Soyanolia to King Waters. Sadida Kitchen Richari Orba, Nijik Soyanol. Siddhusanda, Karsu, that is detached. That is the Soyan Kishus. The Kishus is like this, Kashi said, Dharma is the condition. Yeah. Chen Yamlin chess, Siddhusan, Miss Samuel, that Lea, this is the confusing over the top of your topatism. Kashi, this over that Chebe Jalar, Chebe of Jetang. Ji Benaji Doji the Tribu than Tamaru the Kabala the Disu Ji Kashwe Kwaina Kishu Sarvichi. Chimwada Disu and Juran Kwachine de Kikus. And then you sane Samsam Ji Mizanchi Ganalia Ji got a family member somewhere. Kim Kimi, Kashi, Chel Teba Mia, Kashi, Chel Teba Yene,
So we need to bring Dharma into our lives. And bringing Dharma into our lives, sometimes when we think about this, people get a little bit confused about it. They have some doubts about it. They maybe think that you have to get all the things that you need as a Dharma practitioner. You have to have all the accoutrements of a Dharma practitioner. You need the Vajra, you need the bell, you need the Dhammaru drum, you need the skull cup. You have to get all these things. You have to bring your mala everywhere that you go. And sometimes this brings problems. Sometimes, like if you have a single family, there's maybe one Buddhist in it, but maybe there are some people who don't have faith in any religion. Some who have faith, some who don't. Some who have faith in different religions. And then in that situation, then Dharma can become like a cause of problems and a cause of the difficulties. And it's like you're being strange about it. And so this is particularly a problem, if we're Buddhists, we need to realize that Buddhism isn't something we need to show on the outside. We shouldn't intentionally try to show that we are Buddhists. Now, of course, sometimes it just naturally is visible, but if we're intentionally trying to show that we are Buddhists, then this doesn't fit with the Dharma. Actually, this becomes one of the eight worldly concerns. If we aren't doing it intentionally, if it just naturally is visible that you are a Buddhist, there's no problem. But it's when you're intentionally trying to see, will they be able to see that I'm a Dharma practitioner? If we're seeking it out in that way, then it is actually no longer Dharma practice. That is contradictory of the Dharma. And so the Dharma is not... So if we practice the Dharma so that other people will show, that is contradictory. So when we talk about bringing the Dharma into our life, it means that we are able to apply the Dharma as an antidote. It means that we'll be able to use the Dharma as the antidote. The Dharma isn't something that we only do in the meditation room, and it's only an antidote when we're in the meditation room. If we only had the afflictions occurring when we were in the meditation room, then that would be fine. But that's not how it is. The afflictions happen all the time outside, when we're at work, when we're trying to make connections with other people. That's when the afflictions occur, and that is the time when we need to be able to apply the antidote and work against the afflictions. So it is particularly at those times that the afflictions are likely to occur and that many afflictions occur. Those are the times that we need the Dharma to function as the antidote.
Nyomo le nyembo ten sadi. Nyomo ba di pena. Nyomo le nyembo ten sadi. Kong pena di kondo nyobuzi. Lambi na ta kondo di ma nemje. Lana ya ta di kondo nemje arjorba ta kondo be ngazu pebegi kagi tambiru jore. Kane. Kone member na kane tua madu jagores. Kone member yungores ta. Member na ina numjuru dilia. Kondo la me do do shenema. Chi kashure. Ma kondo nemgores. Tisa. Member na ina tua la yungorwa. Ene nisa. Kobe na member yungor de inea. Ene. Da kane. Kata na ne ta. Kata na sila jagorta. Tua madu jagores. Tua. Invisible, to I am your jaws. Tender which is go, Matadi, pneumonia, nimble dance at the chic casue, ma control lane, but the patchy name che, sober gum che, to the casue, dead there. Today, Mangbush have been a teacher, me Mamboji, did something that go, Mangbo Mamboji, did Mambo style, on a yawoman door. Control Mambo starche. Energy, some things are. Si kasuwe susul dungheye bine ta ta kanta chi di sistemliya di kariye bine ma tuya di keshin paris ta di shigor patri nyusana ta di kasi nyomo nyembo tensa di ma nem de barabachi ta zid de barabachi tenderu samatoa di nyomo nyembo tensa maris ta di ngune shi nyomo pa langda lango ta nyomo Kaisan Dina Locker, Zentab Doni, Dober Show, Ladusane, forcefully some of that in the city, San Pazi, ten double G, some linal ten double G, immediate of the Digi, Corona Yangarva.
Now, when we say that you need to apply the antidotes for the afflictions, like of anger, when anger comes, you think, might think, oh, this means I need to suppress my anger, I need to squelch, I need to stop my anger. We have a Tibetan expression that says, even when there's fire burning in your chest, don't let the smoke out your mouth. So it's like the fire is burning there, but you can't let it be seen. You know, you've got the fire of anger, but you can't show it to anyone. So actually, that's not what it means. So people do think that when we say applying the antidote or using the antidote, we might think that this means you have to suppress your anger and then be patient and bear with it. But when you do that often, what happens is you collect it within yourself. You're just gathering it in yourself, and that's no good either. It's just something that's going to bring more suffering to yourself. And in fact, we're in a day and age now where people say that actually you need to show what you're feeling and show what is on your mind. So people, when they hear it say that you need to apply the antidote or apply the remedy for the afflictions, they think that this means that you need to suppress the afflictions and squelch the afflictions. But that's not what it means. There is the danger. When you read this line, it says, I will confront them strongly and avert them. There is the danger that you will understand it, or the danger that you will misunderstand this as meaning that.
Dream teba meba sana dhado nyomu bara lo lo bara ruchi nyomu bara shemba lo bara ruchi nyomu bara she lo bara ruchi tindu chi chungbu yinbi na ene ko nyomu bara saadi chi tangi sawa na shingi press chiyakwa ara tindu ke chiyakwa asuka mendo tindu yinbi sana kura rangshingi nga tsuyo ki naturally kura karshwe nyomu ki gyöndi ngay singwa de nyomu nyembo tena ala ke shishwe ruchi basic Mungshirubdi, chade yusar samchang yus.
And so that is why it gives the attitude here, since they will make both me and others untame or wild. It's because the afflictions make ourselves wild. We're no longer gentle, no longer peaceful. And so that, for that reason, we need to see the afflictions as being a fault. And then when we have identified the afflictions as being a problem, then at that point we lose our enchantment. We feel revulsion. We feel disgust for the afflictions. And when we feel the disgust for the afflictions, then they'll naturally decrease. You don't need to suppress them. There's no need to squelch them. Rather, you identify the afflictions as being a fault, and naturally they decrease. And so this is the basic, this is the fundamental remedy for the afflictions.
chinangi chagin zorda, chi chagin nanga chagin. Da chinanga chagin sena drado yana to support ni gurus.
And so in order for to...
Shloni support you, naro support you, nan jumul.
So in order to apply a remedy for the afflictions, we need two different types of supports. We need, or two different sorts of things, two different supports. We need an external support and an internal. We need support from inside and we need support from outside.
So, today, And
Like for an analogy of this, if you think about ancient times, old times, like a movie about, you know, old times back when there were kings, you have two kings, King A and King B, and they aren't getting along, and so you're going to have to fight a war. And when King A is getting ready to fight the war against King B, then the first thing, if you're thinking like a general, the first thing that you have to think about in doing it is you have to prepare for the war. So you have to raise an army, train them, equipment, that can get them all right, and then only when they are ready to go into battle, only then can you actually, they're trained and equipped and ready to go in, then you send them into battle. And then the second thing you have to do is you need to go send spies into King B's city, into the capital city. And these spies need to examine the situation. They need to see, well, what's the economy like? How are people doing? How's the army? Is the army good or bad? And they examine this. And then you need to see, well, how is it that people feel about their king? Do they like their king? And so if the economy is good and the army is strong, and most importantly, if the people support the king and if they love their king, then no matter how much war you wage, it will be difficult to win. And so what you need to do is you have the spies need to start spreading rumors, fomenting rebellion. They need to try to get people in conflict with each other. They need to make people dislike the king and feel badly badly about the king. And so only at that point, when you have the army coming from the outside and the rebellion from the inside, the two external and internal conditions coming together, only then can you really take the city.
Depth of your heart, somebody. Depth of your mind. That dinalolia, Susuki, no more. Shell over the Gita, no more, Chello Chag, some of the Mabina. And that the Chilone, Azuzi, Azure, the Chu, Chen, no more, Nimbo, there, Tapsi, Chia, Dang, the Casual, the Chosa, Duba Jang, somewhere where that the number of day are the Pingalmans. Depth of your heart, mind, some of the telia, you more catch hot your emina. No more the top emina. Then you just a caravan, Susugi, some of the nonsense, dear, no more the shamble of chair. And she learned it to me again, twinging, gave a top shamble of this year emina. Then you yam the sober emina, and you move the union number get to us, young goddess. That donna. Tamjil number get to be in air. Tamad social, Janil number gematup, summary. Victoria by yourself, summary. But the Jandi that Jachi Shuri, which is an andado, Ja, the final boss, summary that Shanasa Shuri, the social charity, what the name is that Tijunzel Dene? That the negate, she got away. New Mombalea, she, New Mombi, Guyan competition.
So it's also like that when we are applying the remedies for the afflictions. First, we need to get ready on the outside. So we do the prostrations, Vajrasattva offerings, we do Guru Yoga, we do many different methods. And so these are getting the external support ready, you know, supplicating the Lama and the Guru and so forth. And then when we are ready, then when we are applying the antidote for the afflictions, we need to look and examine ourselves, see ourselves with ourselves, whether from the depths of our hearts, whether from the depths of our minds, we have really got revulsion for the afflictions. If we do not have revulsion for the afflictions from the depths of our heart, then no matter how many things we do on the outside, no matter what dharma we practice on the outside, it will be difficult for it to actually work as a remedy for the afflictions. But if we are doing this from the depths of our heart and from the depths of our mind, then we will really be able to turn away from the afflictions. So the main thing is that we need to be disenchanted with the afflictions within our own minds. And then when we have that disenchantment, that revulsion for the afflictions, and we also have the support of the external powerful virtue, then we will be able to be victorious and overcome the afflictions. But the biggest enemy in all of this is our own selves. We are our own biggest crime boss there. And so we need to look, and if we are able to see the afflictions as being a problem and a fault, then we will be able to apply the remedy. So it is important to understand this.
Very complicated. So that is the reason. Did you nyambo dance at the nyomo basati? Pena nyambo sat and around of che. Nyomo basat, mission does you know? Let our Diana up didn't dish at your mother. Nyomo basati? That sozon of the chad yard. Nyambo dance at the sozon the devil of chad yard. Then you son it? Confusing, Samarvataji. Jijana, Nyomo Bada, figure, Taxi Shane, Pada du San as a Nyomon, Nyamutingi, Gizare. Nabadin, in a Moma Chidusane, Nyomo Bada. Then a sozon, you trouble to garen. Pula Toburene, Diana Nabatelia, Casuaji, Nyamutingi, Gizare, what that mean, you son? Ta, the Dishana. Nyomo nyambo tensa de yomarwa de yuz de yuz de tenta de complicated de de cha de ye binza de yuz de ne de ne ene kaswe na de je sha ba ha ku mu ta da rin
so it can be difficult for us to apply the remedies. It's difficult when we talk about applying the remedies, then you know, if the affliction were one person and the remedy were another person, if there were someone else, separate people, then it would be easy. But it's not like that. The affliction, that's you. The antidote, that's also you. And so it gets confusing about this. And so it's we might be trying to apply the antidotes, but if it's like trying to apply it outside of ourselves, it doesn't work. Actually, we have to look inside ourselves. Often, the afflictions deep in the depths of our mind, the afflictions are like our best buddies. They're our friends. So on the outside, it may seem as if we have the appearance as if we were applying a remedy, but actually inside, we may not be really applying the remedy. And so for that reason, it can be very complicated. The next verse reads, whenever I see ill-natured people or those who are overwhelmed by heavy misdeeds or suffering, I will cherish them as something rare, as though I'd found a priceless treasure.
That
So whenever I see ill-natured people, people with bad natures, people with bad characters, like these are, you know, these are particularly the people that we need to feel loving kindness and compassion for. And so often what happens, we see ill-natured or bad, we see bad people and they experience some sort of misdeed or some sort of suffering. And if they're a bad-natured person, then we think they deserve that. That's often how we feel, particularly when we see someone who really has done something harmful to you, someone who's stolen something from you. Maybe they've stolen your car, burned down your house. Then they get injured, they go to the hospital, and they're in the emergency ward, and you say, you deserved it. If that's how it is, then if you are not able to, at that point, if you're not able, that is not meditating, that is not the practice of loving kindness, compassion, and bodhicitta. That sort of practice is not okay. When we see someone like that, that's especially the sort of person that we need to have compassion for. They're the particular focus. That sort of person should be the particular focus of our compassion. Because when you have other sorts of people than that, then it's easy to have. If someone else goes to the hospital, it's easy to have love and compassion for them. But if it's not, if otherwise, when it's someone who's done something to you, they've hurt you in some way, and now they're suffering, and now they're sick or injured, then that is particularly the time when you need to emphasize love and compassion for those people. And so it's at that moment that you can actually tell whether or not you actually have loving kindness or compassion. That is the meaning of this verse about how we need to develop loving kindness and compassion even for such people.
Did you try that? Did you? That the Interest payment language is that the draw should be curious. Draw should be can touch the reading in Jimmy Jitter in some sort of chenny. That's how many Jimmy Dowers. A child came out of nothing, what's our high homers? In a Jimmy Dowra. I came out of me, I'm some of somebody done that. Tanga Chamney can do the middle dinner, ta, Chamney Jun or Domazena. Shamjin should get some chivy, Shamjin should get some jingrota. Do you know those old money be money jis archer? Dia, dear, didn't she get Chandra Nigorta? Telepa, that jenny jiggle me dota. Dogon cheese lap shana, Yashin the jeans are called the Tambucha. The jenny jiggle me to Tapsin chevy. I tried, but doesn't work somewhere with that. Listen. Yashiro. Same other jig men a jiggy and no door says it. That's the old man being on the ninja that the trail of Chilana. The young shiver. The Kandaria. The Kashre Chamninji gets tissue of the degrees of exam of Chevimina. That's the tick of exam of Chequers. Example, go some tas, Susuki, Loma, Gunjum Buchilla, Chaminji gom, tan, you much tan, everything or water. Same at the Kadu in a gom, the tongue on the car level, the car led in some sort of tobacco over. That in it, that level, the car led, touch a check one. What a tinjagi, Kashway, Simpson, the jelly. Me you to chain, Chaminji gomne, given donor, then a level, Kashwaji, degree, tobacco artist. That is something.
And so when you see someone like that, if that there's someone ill-natured like that, and you try to meditate on compassion for them, if it doesn't work, then it didn't work. That's fine. But you should see, when there is. If there is someone who has done you some terrible wrong, who has harmed you, and that person is now in some difficulty or in some pain or suffering, then you should take this as a really great opportunity. This is a great chance. And you should pay particular attention and put particular interest in that to see whether or not you have actually developed loving kindness and compassion. And if you find that you have not, it's okay. But you should at least examine and see. But you shouldn't pretend that you have. If you try to see if you have love and compassion for that person and you don't actually have it, but you think, oh no, if I don't, I'm a failure as a Dharma practitioner. And so I'm going to insult my own money, pay me home, and say, oh, poor thing. If you actually do that, that's actually one of the eight worldly concerns. Now, if you try to have love and compassion for someone and it doesn't work, fine. It's no problem, but otherwise, if you are unable to feel compassion for someone, but think to yourself, oh, I have to be a Dharma practitioner, I must say Om Mani Padme Hum and so forth, that's not the Dharma. In any case, we need to have a chance to examine our love and kindness and compassion. We need to see what sort of a level or degree of loving kindness and compassion we have, and this is a perfect opportunity to do so. So if we are always meditating and meditating on loving kindness and compassion and we never look to see how much we have, then you know you never really know where you are, whether you actually have it. And so at this point, when there is that type of a being and in that situation, then you can examine yourself and see what degree of loving kindness and compassion you actually have.
That didn't use that name. Then a Buddha said, Yigis TV, no? And Dusva, Kashre, Buddha says, T. Namjuna, see, Tadam, Dus TV, no? Buddha, Gushulan Buddha Tishana Buddha Gushulan Tina Buddha Re in a Gushuladr Mada Buddha Taganan Singi Ranshin Sambu Yavisim Jenko Ranshin Sambu Yavina or Kasu Simjin Rela Ranshin Yabay Yavina Simjin Yabitibare Didu Soye Vichibare Madabe Ko Ranshin Yabay Yabitsamshi Ko Didu Soye Machandraji Yoma Tinidusana Didu Soye Yabitiba अनि जे सिमजिन इबा जिगो इन्दुसान दि गुनजेन देने अनि गाशवे माजु तादान जिगो छिनजिन थोना गेचेमर छादिवार लाबरदो सिमजिन नेबा दिसु जे सांबुलिया ट्रान्सफॉर्म छेतुना सुसुगी छामबादा सुसुगी जवादा सुसु शिरबले देने अनि रंसि नेबे सिमजिन दिसु रंसि सांबुल बे गुरतुबादा जि गाशवे एपा Kasman Jabar Sotober to Chumba Yimina? Dene Kasu, mix egg, Kasu, Kesus and Antando, Sisi Everest, some tangues.
It's like when you're writing Buddha. When you write Buddha, you write it forwards, B U D D H A, then it says Buddha, but if you read it backwards, still the same thing, but it's still the word Buddha, but it's written backwards. It no longer really spells Buddha if you write the words in the other order. But the letters are the same. Similarly, when we have sentient beings, you can have good-natured sentient beings and bad-natured sentient beings. And yet they're the same in experiencing pain and pleasure. The bad-natured sentient beings, just because they're bad-natured sentient beings, does not mean that they do not experience pleasure and pain. Because the good and bad natures are the natured beings are the same in being sentient beings, then they're fundamentally the same. And so we need to view them in this way. Especially if there's some way that we can transform a bad-natured sentient being into a good-natured sentient being. If through the power of our loving kindness or compassion or our intelligence or wisdom, if we are able to make a connection in order to transform that being, then I think that that in particular is a real distinguishing trait, a real dignity for us.
Kanta neba kenyan nuzi, sikamar batasi, neba kenyan nuzi, neba kenyan, da pen tangen ndo la, neba kenyan da, neba kenyan tibetani patena, neba kenyan tibetani kasi yusar samsaro du. Andra yin juzdane, neba kenyan juzdane, denden ji sem pampa yon aji da, anji sem ji dizi kashwe, Oji, Kashre Kunzin, Kunsim Yarota, Shadan or Bri, Dende, Yungudos. Die in a near Kashreda. Try to summon a Tabshi to Chesia. Kandar Kug Ali had never gave a tell a denshin, and a quote Kashreda, never gang in Kasa D, and did look at Soa Yeva somewhere. Did look at Soa Yeva D? Paji. Never gave a tell a dance. Yeah, did you saw you in Batilla, Mazuigi, Yandela Cashway? Ezi Zugurutan, Kuvachewadi, Cashin Bridge, something to use.
Like for myself, there are a lot of people out there, some people who harm me, there are some people who help me. And when there are people who harm me, when there are people who cause us harm, then it's really just natural that we can get discouraged. We can get discouraged, we can hold grudges, we can feel anger and aversion in ourselves. But we should try so that when someone's harming us, we think that we should try to see if we can forget that they're harming us, when someone is harming us, often we forget that that is a person who is also experiencing feelings of pleasure and pain. But we need to try. If we are people who are practicing bodhicitta, people who are practicing loving kindness and compassion, then, you know, if there is someone who is harming us continually, all the time, not just once, but time after time, and treating us with malice and with ill will, then it's just, of course, we're being humans, it's natural that we may feel some discouragement, that we may feel anger towards that person. But as someone who is practicing loving kindness and compassion, we should try to remember that is a person, that person who is harming you is also an individual who experiences feelings of pleasure and pain. And so we should also try to respect and treat that person well. So when there is an individual who harms us, if an affliction arises, that's one mistake. But if on top of that, we also forget that that person is someone who experiences pleasure and pain and think that that is not someone for whom we should meditate upon compassion, then we're just doubling our mistakes. The first mistake is that the affliction is arising. And then on top of that, if we think to ourselves, that harm that person caused me is more important. The fact that that person experiences pleasure and pain is less important. So whatever happens to it is right, the person deserves it. If we think about it in that way, then we are just multiplying, we're doubling our mistakes. And so it's important for us not to double our mistakes in this way. Oh, yes. We have a plethora of questions.
We have questions here. No need, here.
We have lots
enough of questions. Questions. Enough problem.
The first question, the one on top, seems to be the one that was on top before I shuffled. This one on top seems to be good. Dear Your Holiness, Karmapa, how do we help those people whose hearts are not happy, such as those who are depressed or who have bipolar depression?
Okay.
Dear Your Holiness, the Karmapa, how do we help those people whose hearts are not happy, such as those who are depressed or who suffer from bipolar mental disease?
Better to see a doctor. Psychotherapy. Psychotherapist. Another question.
There seem to be several questions about pride. Here's one that reads, when pride manifests in the mind and we think, I'm so good, I do this, etc., what is the best antidote to apply at that moment of the awareness of pride?
Gyalwang Karmapa rwe proud che
de kazon nga je ke de de nga nga de yu nga yapo yin pe me yin da ba ji sam ba shi ke so na o de de du ni la ya ne nyen po kan a kan ten go go de
ji dang ge nam yu de su ga da su su ge wa ge wa sa wa che bu shi ju che ma ge bu de 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 yong wa ma de ji lu ju xie 예버지기 코랑기 뭐네지 공부 망보신 최대 망보신 다나 신기 긴중대 망볼라 코랑 초아 자르제 딱 간다 코랑 그 삼려나 땅 앞에 개와침 뭐 시비지 바지 점불링가 땅 알레 개와침 메스선 코랑 드지 제니 유스로 봐 다이네 코랑기 다 라마치리아 기지 땅에 되게 망보 제비스 개와 망보 사이스 드린 주산 교랑 산 땅에 개와르 드비 Gewa kandriji saadu, tis Kurang saadu, tis tueran rupi tang yung samche. Chidu saadu, ta kurang da gewa kaya yung maras. Tiriji leen gyabari sikduwa. Ta tis suru chichi. Gewa cawa saani, tila ngage gewa yi na, anu gezaan jomdru yus. Tiri sikwari. Ta kandari yang, namju gewa cawa chayabari jesu yirang chayada, di zuu tiri karsha. Susu gewa chayabu tili ya, Joake Jesus Virantiade, Kesim Rije. Ine Susu Geva Shavati, energy, Chodu Guberuzi, Dam, Beha Leveruzi, be extremely summary. The Hajan Tesha, the Jake Santam, you know, this is Mandibuji. Got a Geva Choshi, maybe sad. Tata drew the Kasuri, Matsima, and do tell a flower jita, tell a chi, number Tavaruzi, the Niji Duko Sansanuzi. At the Niji. Dubekiadi, Kesim Shuchadi are there. Rejusane, then Gawan Chosimio. Choshi Chek was the Choshi Chek. And then Gawan Choshi Chevina, and to go on that Chomisheva somewhere. Didn't you start some big one to Chevadi? The Kesim was just the little lunch at the Jumit.
We need to use a strong virtue, a powerful virtue. But not just you must not be satisfied with the virtue. It's like there's a story about about a king. In the old days, there was a king who built many monasteries, built many stupas, supported a lot of different sanghas, and he thought to himself, "I have accumulated so much virtue. I'm so great. There's no one else who has such great virtue as me." Then he asked someone, he asked a wise person, well, what do you think of all the virtue I've done? And the person said, you haven't got any virtue at all. And so the reason is when we get pride, when we get proud of our virtues, then it destroys the virtues. So in any case, we need to do virtues and we need to be glad. We need to rejoice in the virtues that we have done. It is important for us to think about these it is important for us to rejoice in these, but if we then start to think that I've done all these virtues, I'm great, I'm better, I'm such a wonderful person, if we think in that way, it is not. But we must never be content with the virtues that we've done. We must always strive to do more. And if we do that, they will become stronger and more powerful. So it is said that you should never be content with your virtue. You should be content with other things, but you must never be content about your virtues and try to do more of them, and this will help.
Inda.
Yeah, da.
Da, you order gum to catch it.
You order gum.
Let's keep coming. Keep coming. Don't worry. Keep coming.
I have a question.
I have a question for myself. Oh, actually, they have some questions. Part of happening. She can't do it. Dingily, Satan got a choice. They can do
Lassa.
Satan got a choice. The Ting Jang near my guess is said, Art of Happiness, rest.
Lassa.
Art of Happiness, Lade.
Lassa.
He gone to Tibet. Art of Happiness, rest. Tinsangi and a Yamlin Singi Mambuchi. Ani ma kashwe. Seta tan kawiyo ares. Ina yang tuwa lengen di seta tan kawiyo ares. Tuwa lengen seta tan kawiyo nyumon, gomon, deyes. Di kange suto. Tide inju sanem seta tan ki gaba khari inba. Seta khandri shtan kawiyo ba. Di tole ya kiti shiro chisla. Di kande tu.
Asu dik sare.
Ah. Ata di inda.
Okay. His Holiness has picked a question. The question is that the title of our teaching this weekend is The Art of Happiness.
We just know. Art of Happiness.
The Art of Happiness. And one practice that many people do.
We just know that.
Just learn.
Art of Happiness, reading somewhere. Even we don't know when we need to sort of finish. You know this? To funny teacher and translator.
Ooh. So these days, a lot of people take a lot of interest in the practice of life releases. And so, but how do you actually do a life release practice? So the question is, what is the reason for doing life releases, and how should one do a life
release? Which is the best one? Best way.
What is the best manner to do a life release?
Yeah. Tati chedar tonga sa de somar da ji uma nge ji la bre. Tati nge samjar bu che. Ta ji du di ngone na bar ta bi mi nge bas ke amar di mi ne so di. Ka ju da. Chedar tonga na chod ki bar bu di ba ji de in sar so su ka ju vegetarian bu cha di. So, Then you set
When we talk about life release or freeing lives, releasing life, my own opinion, and whether this is right or not, but my own opinion is that the best way to practice life release is to become vegetarian, to give up eating meat. That is the best way. Other than that, we can also do life releases and life release ceremonies. But when we do them, we have to make sure we do them right, because if we do not do them properly, then actually we can cause difficulties and problems in the ecosystem. There have been many situations and many difficulties that have happened about that. So if we just say, oh, life releases are good, and then go out and buy some fish and release them, then that's not how it should be. We really need to understand how to do the life release properly. We need to understand how does it work, you know, how can we do it in a way that matches science? How do we do it in a way that is properly legal? So what is the best way to do this? We need to understand this well, this properly. Otherwise, if we just say, life releases are great, I'm going to go out and buy some fish and dump them and release them and dump them in the water, then it's not even certain that that's going to work. We're not certain whether we've released them to their life or released them to death. We don't know. And so we don't know what is going to happen. So the essence of it all is that every living being, from whether as small as an ant or as large as an elephant, there's no difference in the value of their life. The value of life doesn't depend upon physical size, whether you're as small as an ant or as large as an elephant. That's not where the value of life comes from. We need to respect all life. And especially, we humans want to have food that we can eat. Much of the food that we eat, many of the clothes that we wear, and the things that we have we get because of the tortures and the torments that we have inflicted upon other beings. And so we have to be aware of that as well. So other than that, I have not got too much to say.
Can you?
Not that. Thank you, Duzu.
Two questions. I have one.
Lasso.
I have one for
okay.
You.
I will look for one.
For me?
Refuse
chenarwe mission da
refuge mare te
ane
ding aso de shenden drup na
ha
de
shenden drup tene
ropa ra bachi che go ye na
aha
ane konso de ropa ropa mengo sta bachi samna ya ya
na zulam na
konso sene de ropa
ropa che sa yu de
sa yu de la
e ropa mugo sa
ropa mengo sa ya na konso de ropa yem pringu ma zina ande kan de che go re
ha ta te genza da
So the question is, let us say we are working to help others. How do we deal with ourselves and with others when A, they do not want to be helped, or B, they do not see our help as helpful?
Tricky questions. Tricky? I don't know. Oh, Tati. Some culture different the culture jishung tata mida the view point mida pena ngazu pena puri dubse ana ji sharjo de mina gibu gibu de so ya la de sa ro ja ja ro ta ngazu ya ya la de sa ko so sira ya bo la tu mena ngazu til chin ro ja ja some the chigegi amala de pola de mola de so ngazu ro ja ja chu shishi da I'm not going to be able to do this. Then the physical tone, physical tone, mental tone, shendun drubya. Mi mangbo chik shendun drubya, inji minji pige physical tone, chik chena mado be shendun drubya meyabu saru. Samtang yawari ina kabdiliya shendun drubya saate, so chik mental shendun drubya. Mental shendun drubya saate karisha wajna. Ngara tu tata ninji, ninji, champata ninji meyabu. Mentally, shendun drubya, tante nyi yewe de haa kukwa de keshim tshin mea rosam chenge yis. An daane shendun drubya gub shee ba. Me kwa de mangbu yaare. Tante mangbu ji gugu mea na six parameter shee kwa ya min dawa. Paru di chinpa chuk shee kwa ya min dawa. Tante paru di chinpa chuk shee kwa ya gimse de shendun drubya de tagaas. Ji gaazu chodi dinaan chinpa nan shi lea labu tante yao man ta. Tante yin drubya saane, ane ji gaazwe. Kolia, ane cik swaba, sirup, zunju, ane namji, tak mengubah sanggup ada dengan jurusan di jurusan dia ni, jurusan juga sahaja terhad si, kasur ada cik, kadang asu lelong sempat si, tuju mengubah sanggup aja, dengan jurusan ni asu nampun ki, jurusan sempat itu, ane kasur pernah tuju, kasur pernah. Chakawege, Mahuchi, the Karsan, Jibo, Karsa, Jitu, Jimbul, but Gabatonta, or that Simsi Jig Union, Simsi Jig, Duishi, Gabe Pardo, and Gabe Pardo, Takanda, Nyawal, Negavina, that Ne Sever, Tinjigi, Sever, Sogum, Jinjim, that Ne. Go ahead, the chill, Maradi, in the
Sometimes when you try to help others, there are cultural differences that come into play. For example, with Asians, and particularly with Tibetans, when you see an elderly person trying to get up, you rush over and you try to help the person to get up, and you try to give them help. But if you have someone from the West and you try to help them up, sometimes they don't, not only do they refuse your help, they criticize you for that. I'm old, I can get up by myself, I can manage to do it. And so when you are trying to help others, you need to really think properly about it. You need to make sure that you're actually going to be able to do something of benefit. Otherwise, it's not certain whether you're going to receive thanks or receive a slap across the face. And so when we have an opportunity to help, or an occasion where we can help people, we have to realize there are two different ways to help others. We can help them physically, and we can also help them mentally. Sometimes we might think that when you're helping others that you have to do something that is able to physically benefit that other person, otherwise it is not actually beneficial for them. But actually the primary way of benefiting others is benefiting them mentally. So we can benefit others through mental ways. For example, if through our love and compassion, there may be someone who has a very coarse disposition, who has very little love and compassion, and we can help them become more gentle, more loving, more compassionate, then naturally this is something that is going to bring more peace into the world. And this is going to make a great contribution. So it is beneficial for ourselves as well as for others. And so, in this way, when we are, for that reason, we need to understand, when we are trying to help other beings, we need to understand that there are two ways to do it, physical and mental as well. And when we practice it, there are also many different manners and different methods for practicing it. This is why the six paramitas are taught. This is why we need to know all of the six paramitas, because there are different types of practices that we need to do at different times. So we need to have all of the different qualities. We need to have the patience, the prajna, the diligence, and the intelligence. All of these have to be present. When we talk about benefiting others, then this is something we have to have a long perspective and a long view of it. It's like when talking about the stories of the bodhisattvas who were able to practice the generosity that is difficult to do, or to do the acts that are difficult to do for a very long time, for eons. Talking about having enough patience to be able to bear spending an entire eon in hell. It's not that it's a question of it actually being necessary to do so, but a question of seeing that we are...
To benefit one person.
Oh, in order to benefit a single person, to have the patience to be able to bear staying in hell for an entire eon. Whether or not that is necessary, we need to have such preparations in our mind.
Okay, last question. Tan di chua dire. Tan din du be ge ko zo student zo. Tu ju tong tong ji ge na lo le. Chen ju ge sem ge tu ya te phi zhe yo re es. Tu ju tong tong ji na. Chen ju ge sem ge tu ya te phi yo re es.
This is our last question for today. And the question is there a method for generating bodhicitta in a very short time?
I need to go to meeting. I need to get... I need to go to meeting.
I have to go to work. It's time to go to work. Give me the instructions right now. I need the method right now to go to work.
I think you.
Actually, I think before you think about generating bodhicitta, you first have to know what bodhicitta is, and teaching and explaining what bodhicitta is would probably take a day, it would take a few hours at least. I think to give an introduction to bodhicitta would probably take a few hours. In any case, when we talk about developing bodhicitta, then bodhicitta does not arise without causes and conditions. In order to have bodhicitta, you have to have great compassion first. And great compassion is like the causes and conditions. Great compassion, is, you need the causes and conditions. So you have to have that great compassion. And so the great compassion that you need to have is that you need to have compassion for all sentient beings there are, not any one left off. You have to have the wish to bring all sentient beings without any excluded to freedom from suffering. And so that freedom from suffering, that wish to free them from suffering is the compassion. But that compassion, many people say, is also not enough. You also have to have the extraordinary intention. You also have to have the thought, I will do it. You must have the willingness to bear that responsibility. It's easy for us to say, I want to free all sentient beings from suffering. But that is just an aspiration. What Milarepa said when he was talking about, when he discussed what bodhicitta and great compassion was like, he said that when great compassion arises from within, then it is as if you are surrounded by fire on the outside. So like when you're encircled by fire on the outside, there's no way you can stay there. It's too hot. You do everything you can to get out of that fire. You're surrounded by the fire. And likewise, when you have that great compassion for all sentient beings grow from within, then you have this feeling, I must do something about it. I have to do it. There's no way I can just sit still. I have to do something about it. Otherwise, if we were just to recite a prayer orally, and you look at it and we think, oh, this is what bodhicitta is like, then that's a little bit strange. And so the first thing we have to do is we have to develop this great compassion. And maybe it's easy to develop the great compassion. So first we need to have the compassion, and then we can develop bodhicitta.
Yeah, to us though.
Dear Your Holiness Gyalwang Karmapa, how can we do more for our planet besides doing our best oneself, like recycling, respect for nature, sharing our concerns about the planet with others? Can we dedicate our prayers and meditations to the planet?
Planet.
In
Zadashin.
Sashidu.
Okay. Tati. Tihini, you got to switch it. Zewa. Namju. That Kuyu Sungyup, the Javaris, you on the Orba, Kuyu Sungyup. The Industane. Charge is Shane. Energy in the wounding giggle Tamsella. Simsy Yodosh or a paint was Shah Yuna. The double thing as you chair, then as you goony daddy or it. This is Shah Yuna, as with the Tizume of Drugaji, Nizur Chadi Orba. That the Kuyu Sungyup chair, the Pajitere something you are as a Kuyu Sungyup chair. Kuyulia, and Zishina said this Lia, Kasure, Dawgia Sungyup Shadi, and the wounding giggle Yodosh orla. Pentor Yodebsi. The Mizibo Mare. That the same social Yodos or Pentor Yodebsi Mindusa. Tigus and Dene. That thing was really Chanju Sembeke. Casueta. Chawa. Where Casue. Yamne. Made the Chamber to Pazi Mendelssohn. The little Chengeus. And the Indusan. Tigus and Dene. Chai Oresta. That Chero Chista. Him at the Jinga. She asked him to tell him about it.
This is really related to environmental protection. So if there were one thing that we could do that could help every single being on this being, if we were at this planet, if there were one single thing that we were able to do that would definitely, without any doubt, help every sentient being, every living being on this planet, it would be to protect the environment. For that reason, it's something that we need to do for all sentient beings. It's something that will definitely bring benefit to every being on this planet. It is not something that will only benefit humans. It will benefit all of the beings on this planet. And so I think that this is one of the most incredible bodhisattva activities that we could possibly do. So I would like to ask you all to please do what you can to protect the environment.